Welcome back, dear viewers. Now it's time for our daily press review, and we start off from Al Wafd newspaper, and we have the following headline: President Fattah el-Sisi meets agricultural minister at Al Ittihadiyya Palace. President Fattah el-Sisi held a meeting on Monday with agricultural minister Dr. Hassan Fayyad in Al Ittihadiyya Palace. During the meeting, they discussed a number of projects and what has been implemented within the framework of the president's directive. The president stressed the importance of maximizing the great potential of the agriculture sector in Egypt and work to develop agricultural methods and tools. The president also stressed the importance of expanding the use of irrigation developed methods, pointing out that the agriculture sector is a fundamental pillar of the national economy. For his part, the agriculture minister reviewed the executive position for the 1.5 million Fedans. The Minister of Agriculture confirmed that it was decided to hold a regular meeting of the Ministerial Committee for monitoring the implementation of the 1.5 million Fedans project. Minister also reviewed the ministry's efforts to optimize the use of natural resources and the development of field crops and animal, poultry and fish stocks.
And moving on to Nile News, where we read Prime Minister has economic group ministerial meeting. Prime Minister Sharif Ismail headed on Monday the economic group ministerial meeting. The meeting tackled the development works in national projects and economic reforms. And the meeting also tackled the efforts to encourage investments and providing the necessary climate for the investors, as well as the foreign currency status. Ismail also followed up the market prices file and the availability of the supply goods to citizens, as well as the development of the consumer centers. The Prime Minister said that Egypt plans to accomplish all projects on time, adding that the priority will be given to projects that facilitate and improve social services provided to the Egyptian citizens. During the meeting, Minister of Housing, Dr. Mustafa Medbouli, presented a plan to build seawater desalination plants in the Red Sea region. Medbouli announced that the proposed seawater desalination plants would be established in El Tour, El Alamein, and Safaga cities. The minister stressed that his ministry aims to cooperate with the private sector to build these plants. Also on Monday, the Prime Minister met with Finance Minister Dr. Amr El Garhi and the Minister of Parliamentary Affairs, Councillor Magdi El Agati, to discuss a number of files, including the state budget, before presenting it to the House of Representatives.
And moving to Egypt news, and we read the Parliament resumes the discussion of urgent proposals. The House of Representatives resumed on Monday the discussion of the urgent proposals submitted by the parliamentarians. Parliament Speaker Dr. Ali Abdelayel revealed that the House of Representatives received 250 urgent proposals. Dr. Abdelayel said that all urgent proposals will be referred to the government to take necessary procedures towards the urgent proposals submitted by the parliamentarians. Meanwhile, Minister of Parliamentary Affairs, Councillor Magdi El Agati, said that the parliamentarians' demands will be studied by the government. Separately, MPs Mahsif Elyazel, leader of the parliamentary bloc for the Love of Egypt, died on Monday evening at the age of 70. Saif Elyazel was receiving treatment in a hospital where he died after struggle with illness. More about the late general's life in this report.
Born in 1946 in Cairo, Saif Elyazel graduated from the Military Academy in 1965 and was a war veteran participating in the 1967 war, the War of Attrition, and the 6th of October victory. General Elyazel joined Egypt's Republican Guards and then the Military Intelligence and the Egyptian General Intelligence Service until early 1994. During his work in the Military Intelligence, he worked as the Minister of Plenipotentiary at the Egyptian embassies of the UK and North Korea. Elyazel received a number of security and political and strategic sciences courses in a number of Egyptian and international military institutes. He also received a number of military and general intelligence courses, as well as a course in crisis management and combating terrorism in the United States. Elyazel also received his master's in the political and strategic sciences from the U.S. National Strategic Institute. The last post he assumed was the executive president of El Gumhuriya Center for Political and Security Research and Studies. Eliezer frequently appeared on Egyptian and Arab television channels and newspapers as a national security expert. In December 2014, he announced that he would run in the parliamentary elections. In the following months, he became the coordinator of the For Love of Egypt bloc that won 120 seats in the parliamentary elections. The bloc, whose name has later changed to Support Egypt, compromises around 300 MPs, making about half of the parliament.
And may he rest in peace, and our deepest condolences for the family and all Egyptians for this great loss. And we are joined now over the phone by Ambassador Hussein Haridi, former assistant to the foreign minister. Mr. Ambassador. Good morning, sir. Ambassador Hussein Haridi? Hello, sir. Good morning, Mr. Ambassador. I believe we have a technical problem. We'll be back again to Ambassador Hussein Haridi. But moving to Elium Esseba, Shoukry, Ethiopia recognizes Egypt's right in the Nile water. Foreign Minister Samah Shoukry said that Ethiopia had recognized Egypt's right in the Nile water. During the Egyptian-Canadian Business Council meeting on Monday, Shoukry stressed on the need to take negotiations in a steady pace while ensuring Egyptians' interests. He pointed out that for the first time, the drafting of the agreement is based on a legal basis and a clear roadmap in order to ensure the interests of all the parties. He highlighted the vital need in Egypt to its portion of the Nile water, adding that there are limitations which must be respected by Egypt, Ethiopia, and Sudan. And now we are joined over the phone by Ambassador Hussein Haridi, former assistant to the foreign minister, to shed light on the issue. Good morning, sir.
Hello, good morning.
Good morning, sir. Sir, how do you read these statements concerning the latest developments on the Grand Renaissance Dam, and how do you see the situation on the ground concerning that issue?
Well, I guess this is... I'm not sure whether it's relevant or pertinent to keep discussing talks between the three countries concerned by the construction of this dam. Every now and then, I guess I understand that there is a high-level meeting scheduled between the three heads of state of Ethiopia, Egypt, and Sudan. And personally speaking, I would rather wait for this high-level meeting to take place to see how the three countries would conduct negotiations concerning this dam. But personally speaking, I'm not worried about the consequences or the impact of the dam on Egypt. And I think that it's better for us to concentrate on how, what are the policies as far as water conservation are concerned in Egypt, whether in terms of irrigation systems or consumption. And I'm sure that we would overcome any negative impact that may happen after the completion of this dam.
Indeed, sir.
So, Mr. Ambassador, do you expect an agreement to be reached soon concerning the Renaissance Dam?
Well, I hope so, madam. But, of course, the negotiations are very technical.
Yes.
I'm not an expert on the technical side of the issue. But I'm sure that there is a political will to make sure that this dam would benefit the three countries concerned.
Okay, and back to the press, Mr. Ambassador, we have some news about Saudi Arabia and Egypt. As Al Jubeirah, Egypt, Saudi Arabia work together on maintaining peace and stability in the region. Saudi Foreign Minister Adel Al Jubeirah said on Monday that Egypt and Saudi Arabia are two brotherly and neighboring countries and work together on maintaining peace and security and stability in the region. This came in response to a question regarding the expected visit of the custodian of the two holy mosques, King Salman bin Abdul Aziz Al Saud, to Egypt. So, Mr. Ambassador, can you shed light on the importance of this visit expected to begin on Thursday?
Historically and strategically, good relations between Saudi Arabia and Egypt have always been a cornerstone for the security and stability, not only of the two countries, but for the Arab world at large. And this is the first official visit by His Royal Highness King Salman bin Abd al-Aziz Al Saud to Egypt after his accession to the throne in Saudi Arabia back in January 2015. And of course, the Egypt and Saudi Arabia have a common responsibility in these times of change in the Arab world, particularly in the Middle East, to work together hand in hand in order to restore security and stability, not only in Yemen, but in Yemen, Syria, Libya, and to counter cross-border terrorism. And I'm sure that the Egyptian-Saudi summit that will take place next Thursday would prove essential in restoring the security and stability that have been lacking in the Middle East for the last 5 years.
Yes. Do you believe, sir, that the topic of the combating terrorism would top the agenda of the talks between the two leaders?
Would you please repeat the question, madam?
The issue of combating terrorism, the joint efforts which could be exerted by Egypt and Saudi Arabia in the issue of combating terrorism.
Well, I guess that the two governments are determined, are in full agreement in combating terrorism, not only in the Arab context, but also in the context of the Muslim world at large. And the two countries are spearheading Arab, African, and Islamic efforts to contain and defeat cross-border terrorism. And I'm sure that with such a determination and with such a political will, I guess the two countries, with other partners and allies, will defeat terrorism.
Hopefully. And moving, Mr. Ambassador, to the Egyptian news, where we read the British ambassador praises Egypt's efforts to secure the airport. Minister of Civil Aviation Sherif Fathi met on Monday with the British ambassador to Cairo, John Cason, to discuss ways of cooperation in the field of air transportation and increasing the air traffic flow between Cairo and London. They also discussed ways to restore the British tourism to Egypt. Sir, how do you see this issue of joint efforts exerted between Egypt and its friendly countries concerning the return and the resumption of tourism back to Egypt and the securing of the airport as well?
Well, I personally hope that we will take all the necessary measures and precautions that would reassure countries like Russia, England, Italy, Germany, that security measures in Egypt are tight and would go a long way to abort any terrorist attacks on tourist destinations within Egypt.
Indeed, sir.
Thank you.
And we move to Egypt news. Badr says local elections to be held in early 2017. Minister of Local Development, Dr. Ahmed Zaki Badr, said on Monday that local elections will be held in early 2017, immediately after the completion of local election law. This came during a meeting with the Administrative Reform and Transparency Committee in the House of Representatives to discuss the government's statement before the parliament. Badr stressed that the law would take into account the interests of the citizens. So, sir, how do you read the statements by the Minister of Local Development concerning the local elections law? Mr. Ambassador?
I believe that there is a communication problem, Shireen, and we go on. First, we would like to thank Ambassador Hussein Haridi for his precious input, and back to our press here. Moving to Al-Youm Al-Saba, where we read, Long Live Egypt Fund announces the establishment of an integrated city for slums residents. Head of the program sector in the Long Live Egypt Fund, Manal Shaheen, confirmed on Monday that an integrated city will be established for the residents of the slum and low-income people and will bear the name of the Long Live Egypt. Speaking at the upgrading of the slums conference, she also said that a number of slums in Greater Cairo will be developed in cooperation with the engineering authority of the armed forces.
And moving to Al Wafd newspaper and some economic news and the performance of the Egyptian stock markets. Egypt's stock market gains £1.6 billion on foreign institutions. Egypt's stock market finished Monday's trading session on a high note, powered by the purchases of foreign and national institutions. The benchmark EGX 30 gradually climbed to end the session higher 0.74% to 7,577 points. The smaller and mid-cap EGX 70 also rose 0.02% to 366 points. Likewise, the broader index EGX 100 closed up 0.22% to 791 points. The equal weight index EGX 50 also went up 0.07% to 1,433 points. The total market value gained £1.6 billion to settle at £407.5 billion against £405.9 billion on Sunday, with the trading value reaching £887.6 million for an institutions, were the strongest purchasing power on Monday with a net of £69 million, followed by Arab institutions with a net of £25 million.
Yes, and with that, our dear viewers, we come to the end of our press review for today. And I would like to thank Shireen.
Thank you, Shireen.
And now we'll go to a short break. And after that, we'll be back to resume the segments of the breakfast show. So stay tuned.